I'm supposed to play the final over.
Yes.
Before you recover out of the cyber attack, I want to answer the quiz. What is this picture what you're seeing? Anybody, 10 second answer. And if somebody answers, this is the last ball of the first tied test between Australia and West Indies. And if you go to MCG, Melbourne Cricket Ground, at the entry, you have got such a big size poster, the same poster. And the last man out on the fifth ball of the last day was Ian McKeough. So I am Ian McKeough. My approach is very practical. Friends, as Dr. Booth said, that I'm going to finish everything within 10 minutes. It's like an AK-47 fired at you. I'm a clinician. I'm a hardcore clinician. I'm a clinically oriented, technology supported, and I'm trying to bridge the gap between the healthcare. I'm going to consider the cost. I'm going to make an easy learning, and I'm going to make it reproducible. Gentlemen, please don't take photographs. I'm going to give this presentation. Don't worry. Just listen. Let us start something which can be as simple as a pulse oximeter, which can be attached to your smartphone. So what is the pulse oximeter? It is a biosensor. What it does tell you? It tells you oxygen concentration and pulse rate. But what it does not tell you? It does not tell you perfusion index. You have got a patient of dengue. Patient BP is 110/70. His SpO2 is 97. Pulse is 60 and the PI is low. That means the person is going to be in trouble in the next 6 to 8 hours. So please remember perfusion index when you are checking a pulse oximeter. This is the importance of perfusion index. Do you always require a finger to have a pulse oximetry? No. This is a watch called as Oxytone 1000. It is a wrist watch which can be worn for pulse oximetry. It is a fancy watch, but it's a wonderful way. There are other types of biosensors. Small children, you want to check the bilirubin. Then this is called as a transcutaneous bilirubinometer, which can be attached to a smartphone. And the poor baby doesn't get a prick. There are a lot many other peripheral devices. What are they? Apart from pulse oximeter, there is a glucometer which can be attached to it. And there is a touch B. It is a screen for anemia. You have to just put the finger and you get a hemoglobin. It is a purely Indian invention. There are thermometers like this, soft thermometers, and the mother who is working in a multinational giant company gets what the temperature of the child is, or there is something which can be put in the ear or around the ear and you come to know the temperature on your iPhone. Suppose if you want to monitor a patient for a long time, this is called as a peel and stick continuous thermometer for children, and this is called named by Fever Scout and manufacturer is Vivali. From temperature, let us come down to another vital sign, blood pressure. This is a quadri arm. It is a wireless blood pressure monitor, which monitors 24-hour BP. It locates where you are, so it is helpful for the white coat hypertension. But do you have something called as the machine-to-machine talk? Can your BP apparatus talk to your weighing scale? Can a weighing scale talk to your pulse oximeter? Yes. These are the set of instruments from the same manufacturer. Another manufacturer is called as iTouch, which will be integrating the data on your smartphone. Your patient is waiting, sitting on the waiting room, but your mobile gets all the detailed data. Then even there are weight gurus, like they give a composition of body muscle, body fat, body water. If the patient is having CCF, his body water will be increased. Taking height is sometimes many times problem for the short sisters which are there in our hospital. So you have got this electronic beam paste which can going to take the right correct type of height. There is a BP apparatus which can be attached for continuous blood pressure monitor and the wrist, and it is like an ambulatory BP. You can measure the BP even during exercise related activities like athletics. A combination of stethoscope and echo. It is called as an echo attachment and it gives echo as a superpower. And this is called as echo duo. It detects something like atrial fibrillation, life-threatening arrhythmias. It sends alarms. And most important, it keeps the record. So the alarm goes to about 4 to 5 people. This is a very basic instrument called as a TECG, telephonic ECG, sent on a mobile phone. What is the implication? If it is a transanterior MMI, you will get a primary angioplasty done and your myocardium will be 100% saved. But suppose post-infarction, you are having ventricular ectopics and you are working. What you want? You want to monitor your heart anytime, anywhere. So QuadriCore is a wireless ECG monitor which can which is going to monitor your continuous activity and going to detect whether you got life-threatening arrhythmias or not. There is a patch called as a Vital Connect, which can be applied for 5 days in continuity, and it checks all the vitals. This is something called as a smarter energy response technology, in which the emergency medical team can take decision about medications like thrombolytics or a procedure like giving a DC shock. The model is not the subject of interest. The waste is the subject of interest. And it is called as a Medtronic's Cardio Insight. It is an electrode waste map which maps the heart's electrical function, and you can do map out all the arrhythmias in a proper way. A patient in shock, and you don't want to know whether you how much fluids to give, whether the IVC is collapsed. So this is a butterfly IQ chipped smartphone connected ultrasound. Hopefully it doesn't require the regulations of today's, but it is a wonderful tool to manage shock. Now from TPRVP, let us go to blood. What is a laboratory thing? How you can connect a laboratory to your smartphone? That this is a diagnostic P screen. It can diagnose heart failure, sepsis, concussion biomarkers with a simple one drop blood put on the, and it has been scanned, sent by a QR code, and it is analyzed properly. There are lot many articles around how you manage diabetes. This is the best way, mobile diabetes monitoring, a glucometer which is called as a glucophone, or this is an intuitive medical meter in which you have to just put the finger. Automatically there is a button, it sends you this needle, and the blood is directly deposited on the strip. So you have got the blood glucose monitor, you know the values, but how to adjust the insulin values? This can be done with a pen called as a GoCap. It is a smart device with a common sense. Or even if you have got a combination, in there is a machine to machine talk between the glucometer and the insulin pen, and then decides. Suppose you are tired of that also. A small rice-like thing can be implanted in your skin, and with the thermal energy, it is going to record your blood glucose around the clock. Suppose your blood glucose is low. The only symptom is cold sweat. How you detect the cold sweat? By an instrument called as a hypoband. And other differential diagnosis of cold sweat is either hypoglycemia, acute myocardial infarction, acute massive GI bleed, or onset of septicemia, or cold stage of any fever. That means all the four conditions where the patient is likely to be in a lot of problems. There are digital tapes, there are digital calipers, fat loss and muscle gain measurements. If you have got a diabetic patient who has got a limitation of movement, or he has got a low hand strength, then that you can measure with a goniometer or a hand grip strength. From the hand of a diabetic, come down to the foot of a diabetic. He has a wound, and you want to know how much is the necrotic tissue. And this is an app and an instrument called as a MOVA, Mobile Wound Analyzer, which will take the picture and tell you what is the quality of the wound. Obstructive sleep apnea is one condition, you have to really break the head in front of the patient that this is a disease. But this app, this is going to explain to the patient clearly about OSA, and not only that, this is a small device called as a Sensible Sleep by ResMed, and it is called as a ResMed Mini, which can be attached through a smartphone, and it will show you at the end of the day how much of the person time he has slept well and how much time he was awake. Everybody is aware about these smart wearable devices of your things, which is going to correct to your heart rate and your steps counted. And if you want to really combine two functions together, this is a care watch, and it helps to prevent falls. How does it detect fall? If the person falls down suddenly, and you must remember, a fractured femur is worse than a heart attack or a stroke. Now from heart, let us go to a person who is having asthma. There is an app called as the Go Spiro Respiratory app, and with Samsung, which is going to be released next week in Los Angeles, is a Go Breath. You can just blow it and you will come to know the respiratory function values. There is a Clarify is a machine which is a connected home phototherapy device which will be useful for all the various skin devices. And this is something as funny as any imagination of yours, that this is a tablet which can be tracked in your body. It will show the position, and it is used in schizophrenia where the patient's compliance is very poor. This is a band which is called as the ICOM, which tells you the impending amount of epileptic attack. And this is Indian invention, Manu Prakash. He is the boy who attached a small detector on the iPhone and took the picture of inside of the mouth. It detected the blood, the mouth cancer at earliest. The whatever is applicable to the mouth is applied to eye also. And this is a device called as a Netra, and it is an eye tool for a refractory assessment, or even you can do something called as a PEEK. It is called as a portable eye examination kit. If you have got $600 in your pocket, go for this well-saline examiner system, which is going to telefund us, and you can do it. There are some simple equipments available on the net called as a boroscope. But you use your imagination, you attach it to the laryngoscope, then it becomes a wonderful way of putting in your endotracheal intubation. Those people who are members of Association of Medical Consultants, there is a very good article on this. This is to remove the ear wax or the ear foreign bodies. What this dabba is doing in the time of smartphone? This dabba reminds about time, hourly remember, the vocal reminder about your time, what the time the patient is going to take the tablet. We have got so many gadgets in and around us. I just lost my bag. So if I have got something like this, which is called as a cube or the slim phone wallet, it can pick up, and the moment I press my button, it will give me a second sound from that bag. So this is the way in which you can track your phones and other very, very valuable things. Friends, the chairman is going to kill me if I don't finish in next 1 minute. The next generation homes are going to be like this. How many of you are having Alexa or Google Home? How many of you are having? I've got both. Go for Alexa, go for Google Home. If you've got anybody senior, above the age of 60, tell them, Alexa, I want to listen to old Hindi songs. Alexa will play it for whole day without anything. And I will recommend you that please read, please be up to date. This is the future of medicine. Even though this is the last day, last talk of the presentation, future of medicine is in technology. Please do read it. These are a lot of references, and these are the references from NEJM. Last 2 months healthcare delivery system, you have got so many things. And before I conclude, friends, please remember that you can't ride a horse, you can't ride a bicycle, or you can't swim unless you get some of the accidents. So you have to try it on your own. Don't just listen, and just don't go to Google Play and search for the apps, try and use it. And as somebody said, it is not the machine, but the man behind the machine matters a lot. And not only that, the man, but his enthusiasm also matters quite a lot. So friends, please, use your peripheral, rechargeable, expandable, portable, handheld brain. Not only that, augment it with some attachment. Thank you very much. That's my final word.